So it's you against the dreaded body paragraph, and you need a little help with structure. Well, not to worry. I got your back with SEA Paragraph Structure Review. Let's start by thinking of a bridge. From the outside, it looks beautiful. It's simple, it's clean, it's elegant. It's, well, picture perfect. But inside all of that simplicity and beneath those clean lines is a sturdy structure that supports the bridge. Good writing shares these characteristics. From the outside, good writing should be clean and simple. But on the inside, it is sturdy and well supported. And for paragraphs, that support is found actually directly under the bridge. It's the SEA, C, Setup, Evidence, and Analysis. Remember this acronym for smooth sailing in your writing, Setup, Evidence, Analysis. We're going to go through each of those parts, and then I'll show you a sample paragraph that puts it all together. So the first part of SEA is the setup. This is where you introduce your evidence. You give your reader a sense of place and voice. It's like when you're introducing a friend to someone else. You always say who the person is and what you know them from. Like, hey Grandpa, this is my friend Madeline Sophie Berra. She goes to Sacred Heart with me. Same thing goes for a quote. You want to introduce it. You need to tell the reader who is speaking and where in the story the quote takes place. Heads up, that doesn't mean saying, this quote is from chapter 2. It means situating your reader in the storyline, in the plot. You might say for the Scarlet Letter, after Hester leaves the prison and walks out onto the scaffold, she feels the searing light of midday shine down on her face as hundreds of her townspeople look on in disgust. Now that's set up. The next part of your SEA is evidence. You always want to integrate the evidence into your own sentences, into your own writing. So for example, if you wanted to use this passage that's in the red box in your essay, you wouldn't just start with, "So Roger Chillingworth, the man of skill." You might say something like, "Roger Chillingworth takes on the characteristics of the leech by, quote, going deep into his patient's bosom, delving among his principles, prying into his recollections, and probing everything with a cautious touch, like a treasure seeker in a dark cavern." That quote's integrated. So then you're ready to move on to analysis. Analysis is where you unpack the quote to show how the pieces of evidence demonstrate your thesis or topic sentence. It's not enough just to state that a connection exists. You need to show how that connection exists. If you have good evidence, you should be able to do three things every time you analyze: explain, explore, and connect. In that previous quote, you could explain why this piece of evidence reveals Chillingworth's sinister intentions. Then you would explore baby quotes and pull in tidbits of text to back up your assertions. Think of this as like long division, how you'd show your math. It's not enough just to give me the answer. I want you to show me all the steps you took to get there. So you might focus on the verbs that Hawthorne uses, like delve, pry, and probe. And then you'd talk about how those verbs all suggest Chillingworth's desire to forcefully dig some golden nugget of guilt out of Dimmesdale's dark cavern of a heart. Then you'd connect that analysis back to your topic sentence. See? Explain, explore, connect. So let's put it all together in a little review. You remember the short story, The Flowers? It's the same story that I used in the Finding Theme video. I'm going to give you a sample paragraph that breaks it down and color codes each of these sections: topic sentence, setup, evidence, analysis, and then a concluding sentence. So the SEA is the middle part of your paragraph, and you can have multiple SEA sets in a paragraph. Remember that your topic sentence is like a baby thesis. It's a theme, the same theme in your thesis, and a narrowed down through statement. Then SEA, 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 and your concluding sentence to tie it back to the topic sentence. So let's read the paragraph all together. In the short story, The Flowers, Alice Walker displays through the symbol of the flowers that once a person sees evil or destruction, innocence is lost. In her first adventure out into the forest with her mother, without her mother, Myop skips joyfully while picking an armful of strange blue flowers, full of fragrant buds. The flowers that Myop carries symbolize her youthfulness and innocence. She is so focused on collecting these fragrant buds that Myop is unaware of the dangers lurking ahead. Specifically, after she comes upon the decapitated corpse, she encounters a wild pink rose and picks it to add to her bundle. Although Myop has just discovered a dead man in the forest, she still continues to pick flowers, representing her unwillingness to relinquish her innocence and face the harsh reality of the time. However, once Myop learns the truth of the dead man's lynching by recognizing the rotted remains of a noose, she has no choice but to lay down her flowers. By leaving her bouquet next to the dead man's body, Myop is not only honoring the dead, but she's also leaving her innocence, the flowers, behind and heading toward adulthood. Although she started her day as a naive, innocent girl with a myopic outlook on life, she ended her day and her summer as a young woman, grieving and painfully aware. Okay, let's break it down. Let's start with the topic sentence. It should be in one place and one place only, and that's right at the top, topic sentence. So here we have it. She displays through the symbol of the flowers, and here's our theme, that once a person sees evil or destruction, innocence is lost. Okay? Now let's take a look at where our setups happen. They should all be right before our quotes. And bingo, there they are in blue. In her first adventure out into the forest. Okay, so that gives us place and voice. Myop skips joyfully while picking an armful of flowers. We know who we're getting a description of. Specifically after she comes upon the decapitated corpse. Again, this is giving us a sense of where in the narrative it happens. It's not saying on page two. It's absolutely situating us in the plot. And then the last one. However, once Myop learns the truth of the dead man's lynching by recognizing the noose, she has no choice, right? So we have this part of the story that's given to us through the setup. The next step is evidence. Evidence here is in green. And you'll notice that these are short pieces of evidence, and the rest of the paragraph is quite a bit longer. You don't need to worry about that ratio of, oh, I have a six-sentence quote. Six-sentence quote probably is going to be really hard for you to analyze and unpack. It's going to be better for you to stick with shorter excerpts of text that really get to the heart of the matter, so that you can then focus on your analysis. Look at all that purple. There's like 3-to-1 ratio of analysis to evidence. That's what we're looking for. So here we have explain. Flowers that Myop carries symbolize her youthfulness and innocence. Explore. She's so focused on collecting these fragrant buds and then connect that she's unaware of the dangers lurking ahead. So this is tying back to the sort of progression of her innocence. Okay, take a look at that third one. By leaving her bouquet next to the dead man's body, Myop is not only honoring the dead, but she's also leaving her innocence, the flowers, behind and heading toward adulthood. That one sort of does all three in one. It explains, it explores her actions, and then it connects back to the topic sentence. Again, explain, explore, connect. The final sentence of the paragraph, here we have her concluding line that ties back to the topic sentence, that she started her day naive and innocent, and that she's ending her day as a young woman, grieving and painfully aware, that she's moved from girl to woman. She's moved from naive and innocent to grieving and painfully aware, and summer is over. All right, I hope that we can put it all together and make some sense out of it. Here we go. I'm going to read it one more time all the way through, and I want you to follow how the pieces all fit together. Here we go. In the short story, The Flowers, Alice Walker displays, through the symbol of the flowers, that once a person sees evil or destruction, innocence is lost. In her first adventure out into the forest without her mother, Myop skips joyfully while picking an armful of strange blue flowers full of fragrant buds. The flowers that Myop carries symbolize her youthfulness and innocence. She's so focused on collecting these fragrant buds that Myop is unaware of the dangers lurking ahead. Specifically, after she comes upon the decapitated corpse, she encounters a wild pink rose and picks it to add to her bundle. Although Myop has just discovered a dead man in the forest, she still continues to pick flowers, representing her unwillingness to relinquish her innocence and face the harsh reality of the time. However, once Myop learns the truth of the dead man's lynching by recognizing the rotted remains of a noose, she has no choice but to lay down her flowers. By leaving her bouquet next to the dead man's body, Myop is not only honoring the dead, but she is also leaving her innocence, the flowers, behind and heading toward adulthood. Although she started her day as a naive, innocent girl with a myopic outlook on life, she ended her day and her summer as a young woman, grieving and painfully aware. Well, I hope that helps, and I wish you smooth sailing out at SEA.